and the starting lineups have concluded. So just sit right back and relax. We'll be back in just a moment. Hi, everyone. Greetings from 2K Sports. Get ready for some NBA action. With Richard Jefferson and Greg Anthony alongside, I'm Kevin Harlan at the table. And from the sidelines, it's our Hall of Fame reporter, David Aldridge. DA, it's all yours.
Thank you very much. Now, the calls to shorten the NBA season continue. One NBA president has even suggested a 58-game schedule. And for the playoffs, one and done. He says there's a reason people tune into every football game. The college tournament in 63 games gets more TV money than we do in our entire regular season. The more drama, the more TV ratings, the more money. Kevin?
What's not to like? Everything makes sense. Rest the players, more practice time, and all the things you just talked about. Maybe DA less is more. And thanks for the report. And now the Golden State Warriors starters. The core of this team all out there. Curry and Thompson in the backcourt with Green at the four. Kevon Looney out there with Wiggins. And for Detroit, the backcourt guards are Cunningham and Ivy. Isaiah Stewart out there with Bogdanovich. And it's Duren in at the center, filling out the middle. You know, almost every team has some kind of roster turnover in the offseason, so, Greg, this time of year can be about getting familiar with your new teammates.
There's always a feeling out process this early in the schedule. It's about finding your team's identity, figuring out how all the pieces are going to fit.
Now, here's Stewart. Back to Cunningham. Just five on the clock. Here's Ivy, and Thompson sends it back. And there's the pass to Curry. That's in, coming off the assist from Thompson. Curry's got the first basket of the game for the Warriors.
With all the attention Klay gets, it can lead to open looks for others. Nice decision.
Curry with the steal. Green with the ball. From outside the arc, the shot by Curry, no good. Now, here's Ivy. He's covered by Thompson. Tipped away.
Yeah, that's a shame, because I'm not sure the defense will let him get a shot that good again very soon.
And it's good. 2 points. Curry's got 5 points so far.
Not just a jump shooter. Curry is so creative at figuring out little ways to score inside.
And that outstanding drive and finish brought to you by Mobile One.
And you gotta love the aggression that he had taking it to the rim there. Sets the tone in a close game like this one.
Now, here's Bogdanovich. He had 25 points last game, and the call is going to be... Yes, it is, an illegal screen.
Beyond the leaning, you could see his feet weren't set on that screen. Easy call.
Look, guys get away with this all the time, but on this occasion, he got caught.
Glad we got the chance to see that remarkable rejection.
And making a statement right away, letting them know they won't get any easy ones when he's around.
Thompson from long range. Duren pulls it in. So for the Pistons, their last game, a win against the Hawks.
I admire Thompson's toughness. Gets it from his dad and from his mom.
Yeah, his mom played volleyball in college. His dad was the first overall pick in 1978. Played in the league for 13 seasons. You know what that's called? Good genetics.
Here's Thompson after the basket by Detroit. Here's Looney. Nifty move. And the layup is up and in.
An unselfish wing who continues to evolve as a playmaker. Wiggins shows he's more than just a scorer.
Cunningham finds Bogdanovich. And it's going to be out of bounds. The Pistons will retain possession.
Remain the fourth ball.
Here's Stewart. He played real well against Atlanta in that last game. Cunningham looking it over. And there's the call on Curry. That's his first foul.
First personal foul. First team foul.
here in the first, just under 2.5 minutes played so far. Cunningham kicks to Ivy. Shot clock at 6. Over Thompson. It's rebounded by Golden State. They defeated Charlotte in their last game.
That mental toughness on the road. The arena was rocking, but they just got down to business and never let up.
And the mental game you talk about, a lot comes down to coaching, having your players focused.
Here's Bogdanovich following the basket by Draymond Green. Green against Stewart. Here's Cunningham. Buries it down low.
Just showing some grown man strength there. Cunningham gifted at working through the contact.
Launches it. Curry can't get it to go. Pistons trail by 5. Well, Jonathan Kuminga and Moses Moody, the first lottery pick teammates ever to play in the NBA Finals, RJ, in their rookie season.
Yeah, the Dubs strength in numbers. It got bolstered by some of these up-and-comers. You had Jordan Poole, who was most improved candidate last year. And then eventually, we'd love to see a lot from James Wiseman.
And they're brought in, these younger players, Richard, are brought in that great culture.
Oh, there is nothing like culture. We have talked about that. Culture can directly impact a player's trajectory for his entire career.
Adjustments are a part of the game, and the coach sees something he doesn't like here.
Yeah, this is a good opportunity to get your group together and make sure everyone is on the same page.
Pistons. Noel's checked in for Durin. Bagley comes in for Isaiah Stewart. Bayes checked in for Bogdanovich. And Alec Burks subbed in for Cunningham. Now, here's Poole. Against Charlotte, he was really on his game. Here's Kuminga. Pass to Wiseman. And the officials calling for a 3-second violation.
Detroit got the ball.
Pistons trail by 3. Ivy dishes to Noel. Passes it to Burks. Shoots over Poole. Wiseman with the rebound. The Warriors have gone 50% from the field to this point, 4 of 8. Poole with it, and Burks picks him up defensively. And foul on the shot, so he'll get a chance at the line.
And when you look at the complete game of the Detroit Pistons, there are struggles on both ends of the floor, which I'm sure can feel discouraging at times.
And the first one at the line is good. And looking at the Pistons' recent performance, Greg, which end would you want to see improve first?
Kevin, I'd have to say defense. More stops means more chances in the open floor, and it would help them keep games competitive.
All free throws good from Poole.
For a star like him, you get lots of opportunities at the line, and he's great at cashing them in.
Ivy kicks to Burks. Pass to Ivy. Makes it off the glass. Ivy's got his second basket of the game.
And just so physically gifted, Ivy just brushes off contact and knocks it down.
And here's Poole for 3. Bagley with the rebound. And so it's Bagley with it. He brings it up for the Detroit Pistons. It's a three-point game. Golden State's gone a meager 1-6 from three-point land since we got started tonight. Poole, the pass to DiVincenzo. 104 left here in the first quarter. 2 points, that one goes.
And that's what the pump fake's there for. Get your man off his feet and drive right around it.
And the Pistons decide to take their first timeout right here. They are coming off that win against Atlanta.
And guys, they walked into the arena with a certain kind of swagger, and we really saw it play out on the offensive end.
And they backed it up with their play, got production from everyone, and they were able to walk the walk on the offensive end.
All right, fans, here we go. Time to get loud now for your Detroit Pistons dancer.
And 101 left to play in the first quarter. The pass to Burks. Pass to Ivy. Fires from the corner, and he knocks down the jumper. Ivy's got six.
Not the shot I expected him to take or make, but hey, look, joke's on me. He hit it.
The three from Poole. The rebound by Ivy.
They hold the early advantage on the glass.
The feed now to Bagley. From eight. And the bank shot is good.
Yeah, a natural score. Ivy is developing into a tremendous playmaker.
Here's Poole. Passes it to DiVincenzo. Golden State moving the ball around. Cool, no good. Now here's Bane. So they take the lead. A good close contest so far as we finish the first quarter. The Pistons on top as they end the first quarter on a 12-4 run. And we'll get the second quarter underway on the other side of this break. Teams can jump out in the second quarter. And guys, what's your take on the Pistons so far?
What we saw in that first quarter, they won their matchups defensively.
Making it as difficult as possible for the offense to find clean looks, great stuff.
And you see players trying to get the officials to blow the whistle. Were players in your day, Greg, falling down as much as they seem to be doing now?
Oh, it's way more common now. And let's face it, it's a copycat league. All the whistles slow the game down. I just love to see them let a little bit more go.
We've got Bojan Bogdanovic. Cunningham is out there with Alec Burks. Then there's Isaiah Stewart. And it's Duren in at the five down low.
Golden State.
That's the group for Detroit right now. And there's the call on Klay Thompson.
First
that is his first foul of the game. Kevon Looney is checked in for Wiseman.
Substitution. Kevon Looney.
Burks against Thompson. So here's Burks. He's been quiet so far. Still no points in the game. He hangs in there and cashes in on the second chance points.
He's so strong when he goes to work on the glass. One opening is all he'll need to finish the play, even if it's just a tip-in.
And they pick up two.
And the way Thompson keeps his balance is impressive. Able to fend off the defense there.
Cunningham outside. Pass to Stewart. He feeds it to Bogdanovich. Kicks to Burks. 5 to shoot. The Warriors pull it in.
Even though it wasn't a clear path, he knows that that's a shot he should make more often.
It really turned it around here in the second quarter after shooting less than 40% from the field in the first.
And Greg, beyond the lottery picks, this Pistons team has a lot of young players looking to make a name for themselves.
Second round picks are guys let go by their first team. There's an underdog quality to the roster, guys hungry to prove they belong.
Warriors leading by 4. Outside Curry. Fires from deep. Duren pulls it in. So it's Bogdanovich who brings up the ball for the Pistons. Thompson with the rebound.
And you got to give credit to the D for never giving up on the play and doing just enough to bother him at the rim.
Curry's shot is good.
Just a textbook lead pass right there, putting it right where it needed to be.
Guys, they're looking for a way to score here.
Yeah, they've had a tough time taking the lid off.
Here's Bogdanovich. Detroit, no good that time either. Golden State's gone 1-2 on three-pointers here in the second quarter so far. It's deflected, and that one goes out of bounds. Last touch by Cunningham.
And he made the right read on that play, but just couldn't secure the steal.
And deflections, they're a stat that all teams track. They show who is the most active defensively.
Moody's checked in for the Warriors. Now, here's Thompson. 8 points his last outing. Curry can't get it to go. Pistons trail by 6. And the foul on Andrew Wiggins. That is his first foul of the game.
First personal foul. Team second.
Detroit with the ball. Off the inbound.
And the stroke definitely lacking confidence this quarter. Nothing on target.
His consistency just hasn't been there this quarter in terms of his shooting.
They've settled into a nice groove offensively here in the second.
Now a timeout called by Detroit. You know, Richard, had to be extra special for Steph Curry to set the 3-point record in New York.
Yeah, doing it in the Mecca, sold-out arena. The previous 2 record holders there, December 15th, 2021, a great day in the career of Steph Curry, the history of the NBA.
Ivy's checked in for Burks. JaMychal Green is checked in for Golden State. Kuminga comes in for Thompson. 3 minutes of action so far in the second quarter. Cunningham on the wing, guarded by Kerr. Cunningham against Kerr. 6 to shoot. Can they get it? That shot off. The Warriors go the other way. shoots it up. And that one hits back iron.
And usually that's a bucket for him, but look, nobody's perfect in the mid-range.
Bogdanovich finds Cunningham. Fades away. And the rebound goes to the Warriors.
Well, some times you get the shot you want, it just doesn't fall. I'd go back to him in that area on the floor.
A three-pointer, Wiggins. His second shot goes in, off to a good start, two for two.
And pretty consistent from range. Wiggins has the natural tools to do a little bit of everything.
Back to Cunningham. Played in with a nice touch off the glass. Cunningham's got his second basket of the night.
And they've repeatedly probed inside in the first half, guys, and it's paid off.
That was the 2K drive, as that move deserved another look.
It's all about the ability to get 2 feet in the paint, whether it's creating for a teammate or for yourself.
For so long, the Golden State Warriors were waiting to be back at full strength. But when one guy comes back, it seems like another goes down. The injury bug has been a real challenge for them.
So for the Pistons, Noel's checked in for Durant. Marvin Bagley comes in for Isaiah Stewart. Bayes subbed in for Bogdanovich. Here's Curry. A 29-point game for him in the win against Charlotte. Injuries, though, are an obstacle the Warriors, RJ, have met head-on.
Yeah, it's impressive how they've overcome those hurdles, insisting on still playing their best basketball, even when they're shorthanded.
And they've had a chance to develop some younger players when the older guys, the established players, were out.
Gotta use these opportunities because 5 minutes can go to 10, just like 10 minutes can go to zero.
Well said. Shot clock at 5. The shot from 20 feet away. And the shot is long. Warriors leading by 12. And another field goal in his total. Make it 7 for 14, shooting 50%.
How do you stop Curry? Well, in a short answer, you can't.
Noel. That's in, coming off the assist from Cunningham. Noel's got his first 2 points of the night. Here's Curry with the three. And it's Noel with the rebound. And it's Cunningham with the ball for the Pistons. 6 second difference between the shot and game plan. And finish off by Bagley.
Oh, defending Cunningham, boy, a challenge. You have to pay extra attention. That's when you leave someone open.
Marvin Bagley, the third.
It's his first trip to the line.
You know, this is not an area where they expect him to contribute. You know, he's a guy that shot below 70% last season.
Jonathan Kuminga, 2 shots.
That one is off. So neither attempt will fall that time for him. Pistons trail by 10. And a wide open look for Cunningham. Sinks the triple. Cunningham's got 7.
And you can play Cunningham on the ball, off the ball. He's really a generational talent, partly because of his versatility.
Here's Wiseman. And a good offensive board. And he gets the bucket. And the Warriors lead by 9.
How about the level of activity this team just brings to the glass? Just refusing to give up on plays. And his teammates, trust me, they appreciate the effort.
And so it's the Golden State Warriors ahead by 9 as the quarter comes to a close. And it's been their rugged defense setting the tone. And now we'll send it over to David Aldridge, who is standing by courtside. David.
Thanks very much, Steve. Some great engagement defensively. What's happening that's good at that end of the floor?
think they're just playing hard, rotating, playing for each other, and I think we've done a better job of avoiding fouls and just playing through.
Steve, thanks for your time. Back to you.
Thank you, David. And we'll be back for the third quarter of action following halftime. And now, the 2K Sports Halftime Show.
Hey, everybody. Welcome to the 2K Sports Halftime Program. I'm Ernie Johnson alongside Shaquille O'Neal and Kenny the Jet Smith. Golden State found themselves in a close game in the first. Some good action during the period, as it was just a one-point game at the end of one. It's fair to say that the second quarter belonged to them. They've now got a 9-point edge heading into the second half. Hey, big fella, what's your take on Golden State so far?
They're running the offense beautifully this one, working for good looks. Their confidence looks sky high. It's going to be hard for that defense to disrupt their field.
Over to Kenny. What do you think about Detroit?
They haven't been able to get anything going on the offensive end. And the lack of production doesn't just fall on the play. The game plan that the coaches have, it's whack. It doesn't work.
That about wraps it up. Time now for the second half of the game. We go to Kevin Harlan for the call.
We played through the first half. Plenty of basketball, though, left in this one. Really an incredible game from Stephen Curry.
Man, he's been running wild on them through that first half. Absolute dynamite on offense.
If they don't change their approach in the second half, let's just say his success will continue.
And for those of you just tuning in, thanks for being with us. The second half of this game still to play. And on the floor for Steve Kerr as we get into the second half. The core of this team all out there. Curry and Thompson in the backcourt with Green at the four. Wiggins is out there with Kevon Looney. Pistons trail by 9. Poked away. It's stolen by Green. 4-on-3 as they bring it up. Here's Looney. That falls. Nice feed that time from Wiggins. Looney's got the first bucket of the third here for the Warriors. That was a second look at our Mobile One Drive. Amazing control on display.
And trying to extend this lead, no better way than playing north and south, getting after it.
Cunningham passes to Stewart. Hey, Richard, as soon as your playing career ended, you got right into this business, into broadcasting. When did you decide that this would be the next step?
Well, the first time is when I thought I was going to be out the league, and so I started doing more and more work until I retired in 2018. So it started way before I retired.
That laid the groundwork for you. Good job. Now, Stewart, following the three-point attempt by Andrew Wiggins. 6 on the shot clock. Here's Cunningham. That one, no good. Great D that time from Green. To the paint. And it's Thompson that time on the assist from Green.
Well, we've seen that movie a few times, haven't we? An easy bucket in the paint.
Stewart finds Bogdanovich. Wiggins with some nice D.
And they start the second half with 3 straight misses.
Thompson passes to Curry. That 3 off the mark.
And, you know, he's a threat from deep, no doubt about it, but it just has not been there for him tonight. You might want to change your game plan a little bit offensively. Well, you look at the counting numbers for Cade Cunningham. He fills up a stat sheet. The key for him moving forward, though, efficiency.
Bogdanovich goes in, and that one clearly a foul. Gets the whistle, and 2 shots coming up.
And you got to respect how under control Bogdanovich is. When he's penetrating quickly inside, he makes the D hit him on the way up.
And you talk about Cade's efficiency. Greg on a struggling team, that can be a challenge.
Yeah, without great shooters around him, he's forced into taking tough shots or turnovers. And as the team improves, though, I think the percentages should come around.
The first one falls.
And Bogdanovich is a confident, efficient player, a guy who can play either the two or three spots on the floor.
Alec Burks checked in for Cunningham. And Golden State also making a change. Moody's checked in for Looney. And so Bogdanovich nails both of them. Warriors leading by 11. Here's Thompson, and Thompson throws it down.
You like the way Klay reads the defense and finds the soft spot. Great move.
Now a timeout called by Detroit. Curry with a strong contribution so far in this one.
And whatever the D has thrown at him, he's had an answer. His offense is coming naturally to him because he keeps things simple. You hear that, people? Keeps things simple.
Second half of play with just under 2.5 minutes gone. Now, here's Burks. He's covered closely. And here's Bogdanovich. Lock at six. And the pass to Stewart. Let's it go from the wing. The shot by Ivy, no good.
Ouch. Five shots without a make. That's a really ragged start coming out of halftime.
Basket counts. Curry's got 19 points.
And they're beginning to just flat out fall apart defensively right now, especially on the interior.
Pass to Bogdanovich. And there's the call on Klay Thompson. That'll be his second foul of the game. For the Pistons, Erland Noel checks in for Durant. Marvin Bagley comes in for Isaiah Stewart. Bayes subbed in for Bogdanovich. And we have to take another glance at that powerful rejection.
And a block like that sends a message. One that says we're not giving up this lead.
It to Ivy. Jacks up a three. Klay Thompson grabs the miss. Thompson's got 4 rebounds now tonight.
If they want to come back, he needs to be better.
From downtown, Detroit with the rebound. And here we go. The Pistons fast break. Ivy leading the charge. Warriors leading by 15. Curry finds Green. Here's Wiggins. And he gets the basket. Officials blowing the whistle, so a chance at the line for one more.
First, and not hard to see why they are giving up points on this one. Just too many good looks from in close.
And he's got his first chance at the line here.
And you know, you'll take what he can give you from the free throw line. Looking at his numbers, just really not one of his strengths. Shooting in the low 60s last season.
Cunningham, he's checked in for the Pistons.
And the winner's mentality Wiggins has is commendable. A hard worker who wants to keep improving.
They've been looking out of sync offensively.
Yeah, their offense has ground to a standstill. A good board there, Kevin, but overall they're getting slightly out-rebounded.
Well, RJ, you played against Draymond Green. Do you agree with him when he calls himself the best defender in NBA history?
No, of course not. He's not the best, but he's worked his way near the top. I'll give my guy that. And look, he's a defensive player of the year, and he has been in consideration multiple other years. It's his versatility that gives him such a boost on that other end of the floor.
And here's Golden State. Big run right now going for him, 11-2. Thompson dishes to Green. Thompson passes to Moody. Offensive rebound. And Green gets it to go. Green's got his second bucket of the night.
And this has been a great job of just getting into the middle of that defense and really scoring effectively from the paint.
Now a timeout called by Detroit.
Well, it's been an express lane to the rim. Coach can't be happy about that.
Yeah, we can see over here, the coach, he has some choice words for his team. Words we cannot repeat.
Detroit. And then for Golden State, Wiseman's checked in for Thompson. Poole comes in for Moody. And it's Dante DiVincenzo in for Stephen Curry. Now here's Bay. Shot clock at 6. And again, unable to change momentum here.
And they've only got a slight edge on the boards, but it just feels a lot bigger.
And Green gets it to go.
This is how skilled Draymond is at handling the rock, and he's able to create for himself.
Here's Bay, following the basket by Draymond Green. Ball going up court. Here's DiVincenzo.
Offensively, defensively, they are in total control.
And guys, to go on a big run, get some breathing space, it has to be a great play on each end.
The Pistons shooting a low 30% mark from the field.
Hey, yo, right here.
And the foul on Andrew Wiggins. That's his third foul of the game.
Wiggins, third personal foul, 13 foul.
Seconds left in the third. And stolen by DiVincenzo.
And we've just seen them make mistakes on back-to-back trips. Both those turnovers could have been avoided.
And so it's Cunningham. He'll bring it up for the Pistons. Takes the 13-footer. The shot missing.
No matter what looks they get, they just can't convert to stop this run.
This is snowballing for them. They've got to get a good look next time down.
And so it's the Golden State Warriors finishing the quarter up by a whopping 24 points. A look at the field goal percentage numbers tells the story of what tough defense they're playing today. Don't go anywhere. We'll be right back. And let's take this opportunity now to show you our State Farm assist of the game.
And the winner today, the big fella here with the sweetest of dimes. What a plus it is to have a post player who's got this ability to find.
I feel like we've seen more slick passing big man in the league today than we've ever seen.
And as we head into the fourth, we'll see if there's a comeback in the works or if it's more of the same from the first three quarters. The backcourt guards are Cunningham and Ivy. Bogdanovich out there with Isaiah Stewart. And it's Duren in at the five. That's the group for Detroit right now. Now, here's Cunningham. Clock at four. Stewart trying to get open. Duren, no good.
Just a solid performance on the interior. The rebounding has been off the charts.
Here's Poole, and he finishes nicely on the layup. Poole's got the first basket as we get going in the fourth for the Warriors. Pass to Ivy. DiVincenzo against Bogdanovich. And two free throws coming up. Unable to get that one to go with all the contact. And it goes on Draymond Green.
And I tell you, Bogdanovich is crafty inside. Knows how to get under the skin of the defense there and forces them to foul.
At the line for two.
That free throw missing. Greg, we know a lot of teams using former NBA officials now working as consultants to teach their players how the refs see the game. I guess always looking for that edge.
Yeah, Kevin, I think it's a great idea because philosophically sometimes as the rules evolve, players got to learn how to evolve with them. So not getting the calls you might expect, also how you communicate with officials, I think all of that stuff plays a big role in just furthering that dynamic between the officials and the players.
Now, here's Looney. He takes it in. Green breaking loose. Looney with the bucket.
Yeah, taking it right into the teeth of the defense, and it's a defense that's starting to look frustrated.
That's the kind of aggression you want to see when you've got a team on the ropes.
And another great look at the 2K drive.
And a drive like that one can be a knockout punch. Great finish at this juncture.
And the Pistons with possession here. The Warriors making the shot.
The edge on the glass is the difference. It's allowed them to build this lead.
The tray. Bogdanovich grabs the miss. And, well, Detroit shooting 28%. A rocky performance for them offensively. Shot by Joseph. No good.
Hard to figure out how he doesn't knock that one down. No defender in sight.
DiVincenzo finds Green. Some nice passing by Golden State here. Moody. Here's Looney. Banked in off the glass. Looney's got 4 points now in the quarter.
How frustrating for the defense. You get the stop, but then fail to block out.
And you can see them just deflate after giving up that score. And they know that they can't dig themselves out of this hole if they're allowing second chance points.
So here's Burks, the Warriors making the shot. 11 feet away, and Moody pulls it down.
And the well is running dry for him right now. Nothing falling.
Yeah, and the risk now is that he gets inside his own head. Time to take deep breaths in through the nose, out through the mouth, and let the game come to you.
Pressuring the ball and making a play that created the opportunity.
And as soon as they got the steal, it was off to the races. This is the aggressive mindset that the coaching staff encourages them to maintain.
And the play-in tournament, Greg, is here to stay, but the terminology is somewhat in limbo. Is that going to be part of the playoffs?
You hear people say it's not the playoffs, it's the play-in. Maybe the term postseason should cover both the play-in and the playoff. Something to think about.
First one falls for him. Detroit making a switch here. Knox is checked in. Then for the Warriors, Lamb is checked in for Kuminga. And it's Ty Jerome in for Dante DiVincenzo. And both free throws good for Green. And it's Joseph with the ball. He'll bring it up for the Pistons. The pass to Burks. Here's Livers. He kicks to Joseph. Lets it go with a three. And the rebound goes to the Warriors.
They've shown some strength in the paint today. Their work on the boards has been impressive.
Here's Jerome. And the Warriors miss again. Detroit's gotten off to an 0-for-2 start from downtown here in the fourth quarter. Here's Joseph. Drops it in from 11 feet. Joseph's got his first basket of the night. The Warriors have gone 3-of-6 from the field so far in the fourth quarter. Green breaking loose. And the slam by Moody.
Okay, two hands for safety. That's what they say, right?
That's right. He was ultra safe with that dunk, no question. The Pistons have gone 2-of-7 from the field in what's been a cold start to the fourth quarter for them. Outside, Joseph. Pass delivers. Fires the three. Sinks the three-pointer.
When he gets a quality look like this at the perimeter, he can almost be automatic.
Jerome passes to Looney.
2 minutes remaining.
Here's the triple.
Game. 2 minutes.
Jerome, no good. Ball's knocked loose. Detroit's gone 1-of-3 from outside the arc since we've reached the fourth quarter. Here's Livers, guarded by Green. Joseph has an open look. It's rebounded by Golden State. Looney's got 9 rebounds in the game, getting it done. Out left to the wing, pass to Moody, takes a three, drains it from beyond the arc.
Well, guys, this was never really a contest, just a total obliteration, if you will. And you can safely say mission accomplished now for the Warriors.
As one-sided as it gets today, you know, there were some dominant moments in about every facet of this game for that team.
Yeah, I mean, Kevin, it's hard to think of what didn't go right for them. Game planning by the coaches, execution by the players, everything was just on target.
And it'll mark their fourth win on the year, actually their fifth win on the year.
And so they'll take the first game of the season series, a team they'll only see twice. They're certainly happy to start it off with a win.
And as one might have guessed coming into this game, it was indeed another big game tonight for Stephen Curry.
He was doing everything right, and the points came in bunches. Definitely had the hot hand.
And it's the Warriors with the ball, following the bucket by the Pistons. And that one is good from Jerome.
And they came in determined to take this one. It's going to be a happy flight home.
And as it should be, to be this dominant on another team's floor, look, when you go home, you're going to go home feeling good.
Now, here's Joseph. And the Pistons getting another bucket right there.
Look, it's always great to get into a rhythm, but do it when it matters.
It's a shame, really. If they've been playing like this last quarter, they might be in a different situation right now.
Substitution on the court.
Two seconds separating the shot clock and game clock. Pass delivers. Three-pointer. And it's Looney with the rebound. Here's Jerome. He's guarded by Diallo. Looney kicks to Lamb. From deep. Off target. So we see the Warriors taking the game here. This one was over well before the final buzzer. The fans were waiting for something to get excited about, Greg, but they never got it.
They sure didn't. I mean, they just rolled to this win. They made it look really easy. What an efficient performance at both ends.
It's time now to go courtside as we send you over to David Aldridge from the sideline. David, take it away.
Thanks very much. Draymond, one of the cliches of basketball is that the ball finds energy. When teammates are making shots, does that give you more energy?
Yeah, it does. You know, when we're in the flow, the ball's just moving around. It allows me to play make, and you know, then I just try to find an open gap and take the shots where they are.
Man, it was really flowing tonight, man. Congrats on the win. Back to you.
All right, David, great job. Thanks so much. And that'll wrap it up, folks. This is Kevin Harlan saying thank you for tuning in. We'll see you next time. We'll be right back.